मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई एम पूर्णिमा एंड वंस आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू माई दिस क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश. एंड स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू रिवाइज द लेसन विच वी वेयर डूइंग यस्टरडे. सो आई टोल्ड यू वी वेयर डूइंग द लेसन द एनिमी. एंड इन दिस डॉक्टर सरदार ही सेव्ड हिज एनिमी द पर्सन फ्रॉम हिज एनिमी कंट्री. एंड हिज नेम वॉज ही वॉज एन अमेरिकन which was a enemy of Japanese people. This story is of the time of the Second World War. And then Dr. Sordayo Hockey, he was a man, he was a good man. He was a famous surgeon and scientist of Japan. So one day when he was standing on his house near his balcony, what happened? He saw a man. The man was struggling to stand, and then he fell. Both Hana and his wife and Dr. Sudar, they ran to see who is this man. Finally, they gave him shelter in his father's room. He was given the shelter in Dr. Sudar's father's room, and he was nearly worse to death because of a wound which was a lot of excessive bleeding was there due to that wound. Dr. Sudar thought at first to wash him again in the sea because he belongs from his enemy's side country, but then being a doctor he thought this is not a good thing. It is he had already taken oath to save a person who is from, whether he is from enemy country or not, and then he's hoping he will hand him to the, he will tell the police later on, or whatever his decision he would take, he would tell Dr. Sudar. Now, children, the thing is that Hana at first she also was not in favor to treat him, but now she was feeling guilty for that man and she gave her consent to help her husband to treat that man. But the servant of the house resisted. They started moving one by one by telling that we don't want to work in the house where the person is from the enemy side. Now Dr. Sudar, he told that he was going to he got up and he asked what you are going to do. Dr. Sudar told him, you are still weak, you have to rest. And then children, if turning point was there, Dr. Sudar was not sent by the army of Japan because he had to treat an old general. He shared his problem with old general. He was a bit mean person. He did not want Dr. Sudar get arrested. So he told Dr. Sudar that he should do something to get rid of that man. Finally, he told Dr. Sudar that he will send to his house two assassins to kill that man, and even his body will be removed. Dr. Sudar, he agreed. He thought because he could not see his worrying wife who was having a lot of problem, and the servants were not with them, and the small kids were there, so she was having a lot of problem in her house. Oh, Dr. Sudar, he thought of Hana, and finally he gave his consent to kill that person. And how also that was also decided the old general told Dr. Sudar that he had to open the door toward the garden where that person was sleeping. And there he would do what? He would send that through that open door. He would send two of his assistants and he would kill that man. And even his body will be removed. So this was the decision they both had taken, and the children, all the things will be solved. Hana will not know about this. He will be removed from that enemy. He'll be removed from their house. They don't have to even give to the police. And then they will be safe also. Nobody will come to know about it. So children, Dr. Sudar was waiting for that man to be killed. Okay. That night, the day when the fix exactly when it was fixed that when that man would be killed. That night Dr. Sudha was not able to sleep. Why? Because he was waiting for those two assassins to kill. Even the children falling of the twigs and the rustling of the wind make Dr. Sudha very alert, and he was listening that how they are going to kill that man. Well, so I'm in page number 36. No, we were here at page number 42. Okay, so I'm going to read from here. Sudha slept badly that night. Time and time again he woke thinking he heard the rustling of footsteps, the sound of a twig broken or a stone displaced in the garden, a noise such as man might make who carried a burden. So children, again and again Dr. Sudha was he woke thinking he heard the rustling of the footsteps, the sound of twig broke or a stone displaced in the garden, and he was thinking that man must be killed by the two assistants sent by the general, and they might be carrying his body. The next morning he made the excuse to go first into the guest room. Now children, anyhow he made some excuse. He told he did not tell anything to his wife, but he made an excuse to go into that guest room, and he thought that he would have died and his body must have been removed. If the American were gone, he then could simply tell Hana that so the general had directed. Now Sindhan, he was also thinking that if his body will remove, he will tell Hana about the general and his plan, and whatever was done, it was done at the direction of general. But when he opened the door, he saw at once that there on the pillow was a shaggy blonde head. But Sindhan, when he opened the door, he saw that in the pillow his head was lying, that he was... he did not die. He could hear the peaceful breathing of sleep, and he closed the door again quietly. He is asleep, he told Hana. He is almost well to sleep like that. What shall we do with him? Hana whispered her old refrain. Sudha shook his head. I must decide in a day or two, he promised. So he told Hana that he would decide in a day or two that what he had to do with that man. Sudha shook his head. I must decide in a day or two, he promised. But suddenly he thought the second night must be the night. There was a wind at night, and he listened to the sound of bending board and whistling partition. Now children, he thought due to some reason that man must not have been, the two assistants must have not been killed at man. So he thought that the rustling, whenever he heard the bending boards and whistling partition, he thought two assistants must have killed two, have come to kill that man. Hana woke too. Ought we not to go and close the sick man's partition? Hana, she also woke up, and he told that ought we not to go and close the sick man's partition? She said, no, Sir Dao said. He's able now to do it for himself. Now, he was thinking that somebody has come to kill him. But here Hana is telling him, should we close that partition? He told no. Now he is capable of doing himself. Let him do. In fact, children, he did not want Hana to see all that those things. But suddenly he thought the second night must be the night. There was a wind that night, and he listened to the sound of bending boards and whistling partition. Hana woke too. Ought we not to go and close the sick man's partition? She asked. No, Sudha said. He is able now to do it for himself. But the next morning the American was still there. Then the third night, of course, must be the night. The wind changed to quiet rain, and the garden was full of the sound of dripping caves. Now children, second now a night also Dr. Sudha did not, he went and checked, and he saw that he was not killed. He was simply lying on his bed. So he told, what shall we do with him? Hana whispered her old refrain. Sudha shook his head. He told, I must decide in a day or two, he promised. But suddenly he thought the second night was with the night. Now children, he was waiting for the second night that the man must be killed, but he was not killed. ओके हना वोक टू देन अचीव हर्ड ए वन नाइट द सेकेंड नाइट दे हैव हर्ड ए लॉट ऑफ साउंड ऑफ बेंडिंग बोज एंड विस्लिंग पार्टीशन हना वोक टू ought we not to go and close the sick man's partition she told Kibichi wanted to go and close that sick man's partition so he told no he's able now to do for himself but the next morning the American was still there so this time they thought that he was here he must be killed by the assassin sent by the old general but when they went there he was still sitting then the third night of course must be the night now he told me this is the third night and definitely he would be asked to he will be killed So Dao slept a little better but he woke at the sound of a crash and leaped to his feet. Now children, so Dao was not able to sleep. He thought that today 100% the first assassin will come to kill him. Okay, he started, he woke whenever he heard a small sound also and he used to leap to his feet. What was that? Hana cried. The baby woke at her voice and began to wail. Now children, Hana When she cried, she told me, why, what is happening? And children, the baby woke at her voice and it began to wail. Wail means cried loudly. I must go and see. But he held her and would not let her move. Now he told me, no, you will not go and you sit here. So now she cried, what is the matter with you? Don't go, he muttered, don't go. He simply told me, no, you will not go there and you will not go there. His terror infected her and she stood breathless waiting. They were only silent. Now she could taste terror in the eyes of Sodao. And children, she stood breathless, waiting. They were only silent. Together, they crept back into the bag, the baby between them. Now children, both of them, they went to the bed and the baby was sleeping between them. Yet when he opened the door of the guest room in the morning, there was the young man. So children, this time, Dr. Sodao, he thought the 100% he must have been killed. So children, next morning he opened the door of the guest room in the morning, but then he was shocked that the man was sitting there. He was not killed. He was very gay and had already washed and was now on his feet. Now children, Dr. Sodao, he felt that he was very happy. Gay is very happy. He already washed, that means he had already taken his bath and was now on his feet. That means now he can do his small work by himself. He don't have to need any help of Hana or anybody else. He had asked for a razor yesterday and had shaved himself. Now children, yesterday he even asked for the razor and he had shaved himself, and today there was a faint color on his cheek, and today the color of the cheek was a faint color of the cheek was visible. I'm well, he said joyously. Now he told to Dr. Sodao, I'm quite well. Sodao drew his kimono round his weary body. He could not, he decided suddenly, go through another night. It was not that he cared for the young man's life. No, simply it was not worth the strain. Now children, Sodao thought that today also the general did not send anybody to kill him. Though he was 100% sure that he would be dying today, but today also he was saved. You are well, Sodao agreed. He lowered his voice. You are so well that I think if I put my boat on the shore tonight with food and extra clothing in you, you might be able to row to that little island not far from the coast. Now children, the three night was a children horrible night for Dr. Sodao. Three nights he could not sleep. And children, the whole family was already in strain. So children, Dr. Sodao, he took a decision by himself only. He thought that now he will not wait for anybody, for general or anybody to kill that man. He would do something for that. Now children, he had already saved that man. So he did not want that he should be killed by his own hand. He told that now you are well. He told me, I will be giving you a boat and you are now quite, you have gained your strength. You can row that boat to the island which are there in front of my house. From this coast, you can see the island also. And it is so near the coast that it has not been worth fortifying. Now he told me that island is very near. If you will see from our house, it is very near to us. And it is not worth fortifying. So So he told that now you can, I will be giving you a boat, you can row that boat on the shore tonight, and I will give you food with extra clothing in you, and some clothes you can keep, extra clothing. You might be able to row to that little island, but not far from the coast. Now he is told that you can row that boat, and this is, that island is not very much far away from this coast. It is so near the coast that it has not been worth fortifying. Fortifying means building of a fort. Nobody lives on it because in storm it is submerged. Now children, he told you will not, you don't have to fear, as nobody lives here. And in the storm, children, whenever the storm is there, the whole island is submerged. So that's why nobody lives here. But this is not the season of a storm. You could live there until you saw a Korean fishing boat pass by. Now he told me, now this is, as this is not the season of a storm, so you will be safe. And but this is not the season of a storm. You could live there until you saw a Korean fishing boat pass by. The pass quite near the island because the water is many fathom deep. He told me the water is many fathom deep, so you cannot pass. That the pass quite near the island because the water is many fathom deep there. The young man stared at him, slowly comprehending. Do I have to be asked? I think so, Sudhao said gently. You understand, it is not hidden that you are here. I think so, Sudhao said gently. You understand, it is not hidden that you are here. So, I think so, Sudhao said gently. You understand, it is not hidden that you are here. So, children, he told ki, do I have to go like this? He told ki, yes, because you are hidden here, and if somebody will complain, the whole family will be troubled, including your life will be in trouble. The young man nodded in perfect comprehension. Okay, he said simply. He told me, okay, I will do it. Sudhao did not see him again until evening. Now Sudhao did not went to his room purposely till evening. As soon as it was dark, he had dragged the stout boat down to the shore. Now children, when there was a dark, Dr. Sudhao, he dragged the stout boat down to the shore, and in it he put food and bottled water, and children, in that he put some food and he put some water bottle that he had bought secretly during the day. And children, that water bottle he bought very secretly during the daytime, as well as two quilts he had bought at a pawn shop, and from the pawn shop he had purchased two quilts also. The boat he tied to a post in the water. Now children, he tied a boat, okay, to a post in the water, for the tide was high, so it was a high tide. So children, he tied a boat to a post in the water. Post, when children, you can write pillar. The meaning of post is pillar. And stout is actually, stout means fat, but here it means strongly built. And then he told that there you will not sit in any boat except the Korean fishing boat. You will be safe there. There was no moon and he worked without a flashlight. Now he told me that it was a very dark night without any moon, and he worked without a flashlight. When he came to the house, he entered as though he were just back from his work, and Suhana knew nothing. Yumi was here today, she said, as she served his supper. Though she was so modern, still she did not eat with him. Yumi cried over the baby. She went on with a sigh. She misses him so. Now children, that day Yumi also cried. When he came to the house, he entered. He thought he were just back from his work, and Suhana knew nothing. Yumi was here today, and then he saw Yumi was also there, as she served his supper. Though she was so modern, still she did not eat with him. Yumi cried over the baby. She went on with a sigh. She misses him so. The servant will come back as soon as the foreigner is gone, Sudhao said. Now he is also started thinking, as soon as everybody will go, the servant will come back. He went into the guest room that night before he went to bed himself and checked carefully the American's temperature. Now children, each that day, very silently he went to his bedroom. He checked his temperature the state of the wound. He checked his wound also and his heart also and pulse. Everything was checked by Dr. Sudhao, because now after that they would be meeting. The pulse was irregular, but that was perhaps because of excitement. Now children, he felt that the pulse was irregular, but that was due to the excitement, as he was going, he might be saved and to return back to his country. The young man's pierced lips were pressed together and his eyes burned. Only the star on his neck were red. Now children, he was pressing his life. Maybe he was in excitement and his eyes burned. Only children, the scars on his neck were red. Otherwise, he was very much, he has returned to the normalcy. He was looking very much normal. I realize you are saving my life again, he told Sudhao. Now he told me, I am feeling that once again you are going to see, you are saving my life. Not at all, Sudhao said. It is only inconvenient to have you here any longer. No, he told me, it's not like that also. We are also facing a lot of inconvenience as long as you will stay here with us. He had hesitated a good deal about giving the man a flashlight. No, children, he did wanted to give the flashlight to that man, but he had decided to give it to him. After all, it was a small one, his own, which he used at night when he was called. So children, that flashlight, whenever he was called urgently or he was called suddenly to check the patient, he used to carry that flashlight with him. It was a small flashlight, but he had given that flashlight also to him. If your food runs out before you catch a boat, now he said, maybe you will not get a boat, okay? And if your food runs short, he told me, if your food will pick the finish, he said, signal me two flashes at the same instant the sun drops over the horizon. He told me, when the sun will drop at the horizon, when still the daylight is there, then you have to flash twice. Do not signal in darkness, for it will be seen. He told me, at any cost, you will not lit the flashlight in darkness, because it will be watched by many people and they will come here to find you. If you are here, all right, but still there, signal me once. If you are all right, but still there, signal me once. He told me, if everything is okay, then also you have to signal me once. You will find fresh fish easy to catch, but you must eat them raw. A fire would be seen. He also gave instruction that lot of fresh fish is there. You can eat that fish, but then you have to eat it raw, because if you will burn a fire due to the smoke of the fire, and everybody will see you. Okay, the young man breathed. Now children, young man told okay. He was dressed now in the Japanese clothes. Now children, he put the clothes of Dr. Sudhao. He was dressed now in the Japanese clothes which Sudhao had given him. And at the last moment, Sudhao wrapped a black cloth about his blonde hand. And children, finally children, when he was leaving, he wrapped a black color cloth around his blonde hand. Now Sudhao said, the young American without a word shook Sudhao's hand warmly. Now Sudhao told him to move. The young American without a word, he did not speak any word, but he shook Sudhao's hand warmly and then walked quite well across the floor and down the step into the darkness of the garden. Now children, very quietly he left the place and down he went towards the stair and vanished into the darkness of the garden. But that would not be suspected. He waited until from the shore there was one more flash. Then he crossed the partition. That night he slept. Now children, then he crossed it. Okay, no more flash was to be seen. And then he closed the partition. That night he slept. Now children, that night he slept very soundly. You say the man escaped, the general asked him. Now children, next day he told to the general. He told that he had escaped. Somehow he had escaped from his house. You say the man escaped, the general asked faintly. He had been operated upon a week before. An emergency operation to Mr. Sudhao had been called in the night. Now children, he had been operated. It was an emergency operation led by Dr. Sudhao. And then for 12 hours, Sudhao had not been sure the general would live. And children, for 12 years, even Sudhao was not sure that the general would live or he would die. The gallbladder was much involved. Then the old man had begun to breathe deeply again and to demand food. Now children, after that, he started taking a deep breath, and then there was a demand for food. So Dao had not been able to ask about the assistance. So Dao wanted to discuss about the assistance, but he did not get any time. Even the time was not appropriate because he was almost in a very serious or a critical condition. So he thought it was not a proper time to ask. The servant had returned and Yumi had cleaned the guest room thoroughly and had burned sulfur in it to get the white messy smell out of it. So then all the servant had also returned when they came that he is no more in their house. Yumi has burned sulfur also so that they get the white messy smell out of it. Nobody said anything. Nobody told or discussed about that prisoner anymore. Only the gardener was cross because he had got behind with his cherry sampleworms. Now children, only cross means children angry. Okay, he was angry because one kind of flower children, what is this? Cherry sampleworm is a flower, and because children, I think that was already not looked properly and it was spoiled. But after a week, sort of felt the general was well enough to be spoken to about the prisoner. Now children, after a week, general was okay. He returned back to his normal routine of life. So Dao thought it is proper to ask something about the prisoner. He wanted to speak with him. Yes, excellently, he escaped, so Dao now said. He told that yes sir, he had escaped that day. He coughed, signifying that he had not said all he might have said, but was unwilling to disturb the general further. Now children, he did not want to disturb also general further. So he coughed, but the old man opened his eyes suddenly. "That prisoner," he said with some energy, "did I not promise you I would kill him for you?" Now children, suddenly general remember that he told that he had promised him that he would be killing him for him. "You did, excellency," Sudhao said. Well, the old man said in a tone of amazement. "So I did, but you see, I was suffering a good deal. The truth is, I thought of nothing but myself. In short, I forgot my promise to you." The children, at first, he thought that he did not do purposely, but then when general told him that I had become so mean, I was suffering so much that I forgot my promise. "I wonder, your excellency," Sudhao murmured. Now Sudhao murmured, okay, that's why he was telling. Sudhao murmured, "That's why you did not send. I was worrying why you did not send anybody. But you understand, it was not lack of patriotism or dereliction on duty." Now he told me, "It was not because I am not a patriotic person and I did not want to kill him. It was just because of I have become a bit mean and I was just thinking of myself. And it was not a dereliction of duty." He looked anxiously at his doctor. If the matter should come out, you would understand that would not be you. He told the doctor, "If the matter will come out, you would understand that would not you?" "Certainly, your excellency," Sudhao said. He suddenly comprehended that the general was in the palm of his hand and that as a consequence, he himself was perfectly safe. Now, he was thinking that general was very safe now. "I can swear to your loyalty, excellency," he said to the old general, "and to your zeal against the enemy." Now he told me, "I know you are very much keen against that enemy. You are a good man," the general murmured and closed his eyes. "You will be rewarded," he told me. But Sudhao, searching the spot of black in the twilight sea that night, had his reward. Sudhao already got his reward, children. That day when he was looking towards the sea, what did he find? He found that there was no break of life in the dust. So he could not see the flesh in the flesh of that the torch which was given to him to that American fellow. That day no break of light was to be seen. No, he knew that he had left the island. No one was on the island. His prisoner was gone, safe, doubtless, and he was hoping that he must have gone until unless he felt safe. So, and without doubt, children, now he was happy. For he had warned him to wait only for Korean fishing boat. He knew that he must have set only a Korean fishing boat, otherwise all the boats were not safe for him. He stood for a moment on the veranda, gazing out to the sea from whence the young man had come that other night. Children, he started to pick the place from where that young man had come from the sea the other night. And into his mind, although without reason, there came in other white faces he had known, the professor at whose house he had met Hana, a dull man and his wife had been a silly talkative woman. Naturally, he started remembering till now how many Americans he had met. Okay, so he had met a prisoner, he had met his professor, his wife, who used to talk very much. He remembered his old teacher of anatomy who had been so insistent on mercy with the knife, and then he remembered the face of his fat and sternly landlady. He had great difficulty in finding a place to live in America because he was a Japanese, and children, at that time he remembered the name face of the landlady who had given him shelter, because in America nobody used to give shelter to the Japanese people. The Americans were full of prejudice, and it had been bitter to live in it, knowing himself their superior, how he had despised the ignorant and dirty old woman who had at last consented to house him in her miserable home. So he is telling, he started thinking about his children, that woman who had allowed him to stay in his house. Despise means hated, who really hated, but then she had given shelter to him in his house. He had once tried to be grateful to her because she had in his last year nursed him through influenza, but it was difficult, for she was no less repulsive to him in her kindness. He also remembered when he was suffering from influenza, that lady had helped him. So, for she was no less repulsive to him. Repulsive means she was, though she was hateful, but then she used to take care when he was ill. Now he remembered the youthful, haggard face of his prisoner, white and repulsive. Haggard means lean and thin. He remembered the lean and thin face of his prisoner, who was white and he was repulsive. Strange, he thought, I wonder why I could not kill him. Now he was thinking that it is so difficult to kill him. I don't know, though he belongs from the enemy side, but then also I could not kill him. So children, with this I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.